something I've never seen before on a tractor. I mean, it doesn't get much easier than that. You know, I lied. There's actually two things I've never seen on a tractor. Coolest thing I've ever seen on a tractor. It's just really mind-blowing. Isn't that the coolest thing you just ever seen? Guys, how we doing? Welcome to Good Works Tractors. I love showing you guys cool things, and I've got something special for you today. From the front of this machine to the middle, all the way to the backside, this thing has remotes galore, more than I've ever seen on a piece of equipment. So if you're looking for ideas on how to equip your tractor, how to get it set up, then maybe this will inspire you. And as always, if you wouldn't mind, give me a thumbs up, even a thumbs down, hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already, and read through that description below. If you think you like this tractor, you can get more information down there. You're looking for a tractor attachment, all sorts of cool stuff for tractor owners. So this tractor right here is going to be a Kubota L6060. It's part of the Grand L series of tractors that are offered by Kubota, the largest or the biggest compact tractor that you can get on the market. Competes very well with the John Deere 4066, for example. On a machine like this, you would expect it to come with a lot of bells and whistles, and it does, even standard. However, this one goes well above and beyond that, equipped with features such as an air ride seat. It even has a canopy up here with a built-in fan to keep you cool in the summertime. However, the highlight for me, and the reason I bought it as soon as I saw it, was just the plethora of remotes, which allow for additional hydraulic functions to take place. Let's go through those now. Okay, so we're on the back side of the tractor here. This is typically where you find most of your additional remotes that you would have. Let me back up really quick there and explain what a remote is. So you already have two SCVs, selective control valves, on your tractor if you have a front end loader. One SCV will have hoses, two hoses for it, okay? It makes a circuit. It's gonna have hydraulic oil that goes one way to make your loader raise up, and then it's gonna flow through the other way to make your loader go down. So that's SCV number one. SCV number two is gonna be the other function that your loader can do, which is to curl a bucket up or dump a bucket or roll a bucket down, or whatever else you have attached to it. This tractor not only has those two main or primary SCVs, it's got six additional functions on top of that. It's just really mind-blowing. I'm gonna start in the back here, show you what these are all about. I'm gonna save the best for last all the way up front, something I've never seen before on a tractor. This may not be in a particular order. I'm gonna call this SCV 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 that are back here on the back side of the tractor. So tucked back in here without anything plugged into the ports, you're gonna see four of these ports right here. Now again, two ports equals one SCV or one hydraulic circuit. It equals one additional function. So you've got two ports up top, that's a function. You've got two ports down below, that's also a function. What you're also gonna see tucked back here are gonna be the cylinder right here in place of the typical top link that you would see. You're also going to see another cylinder over on this side link. This is called a top and tilt kit, something that you don't see all that often. You may have seen it in some other videos that I did. I'm particularly fond of it, but it is a pricey option to get. Not everybody needs it, but it will help with several things. It'll help with hooking up to attachments because you can, from your operator seat, extend or retract a cylinder either way. You could extend your top link to maybe push that out if you have a quick hitch on there to maybe catch a ballast box or a box blade, whatever you're trying to hook up to. With a side link, you could do that same thing. You know, if it's on an uneven piece of ground, or if you're actually doing some work with it. Say you're grading a road and you wanna get a nice crown in the middle of that road. You can, in particular, use this side link here to offset, to make it out of balance or off level your grader box or your rear blade or a land plane, whatever it is that's on there, to take more material to one side versus the other and help crown that road for proper drainage. Okay, so now we're here at the midpoint of the tractor, the mid SCV area, you might hear this called as well. So typically here you would have just four hoses, all right? You'd have Pioneer couplers or egg style couplers, could be flat face couplers too, just depending on your machine. But typically you're not gonna have this whole gaggle of hoses and connections right here. There's a way that this has all been simplified, believe it or not. It looks very confusing and there's lines going everywhere, but there's a very cool system here called a single point connection. The manufacturer here is really disappearing. I can see Faster made out, but then everything else has kind of faded away. But looks like a really sweet system here. Very easy to use. You simply push in a little red button. You flip up on it like that on the handle, and then you wiggle it out. And then everything, let's see. How many hoses are here? There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 hoses that I just disconnected with a single lever. I mean, it doesn't get much easier than that. And so yeah, a feature like a single point hydraulic connection is really a convenience feature. Really, remotes are a convenience feature in general. I mean, you could do things the old-fashioned way, right? But cool features like this are kind of what set things apart. Also, you know, if you had only four hoses here to connect or disconnect, yeah, you know, that'd be a fine job to do. But when you have six or eight hoses like what you see here, if you want to take your loader off, that's quite a bit of work to do, you know, and especially when they're all so close together, can be kind of a pain to work with at times, especially, you know, as you get older, the hands get, you know, more arthritis and anything else going on. A feature like this can really come in handy. So again, I think it's faster. Look up faster, quick connect or something along those lines online. You might be able to find some more information if you're looking for a product like that. Okay, so now we're to the front end of the tractor here, and you know, I lied, okay? I said there was one thing up here I had never seen. There's actually two things I've never seen on a tractor before, until now, okay? So this is something new for me on both accounts here. Really cool. So first one right here is gonna be another single point connector that's up front here. Now this right here would be good for connecting hydraulics for a grapple to, or for a hydraulic angling snowblade, something along those lines, where basically, I mean, it's just a simple operation, kind of like what the mid PTO, or the, I'm sorry, the mid SCV version was. Same concept up here. I've never seen this before. You can see a little bit easier up here. It says faster again, right on that cover. I mean, this is just a really cool concept. You'd have to reach out to them to get the mating end of this if you ended up buying this machine in particular. But I got to imagine you just grab a couple of hoses like what you're gonna have coming off of your hydraulics on your front blade or on the grapple up here, and just mate it up with the other end of this single point connection right here, and away you go. Really simplifies that process. So let me take you up into the operator station to show you how you would control this function right from the driver's seat. So what you're gonna see right here in the loader joystick, this little extra control that's clamped right down to it and a little wire going down. So this is called an electric over hydraulic third function, or maybe a diverter valve, you'll hear it called. So what this does on this particular setup, you push this button that's gonna activate the solenoid. And that's essentially, I believe anyway, my interpretation, going to temporarily divert the flow or temporarily allow flow to go to that third function, which is gonna control again the opening and closing motion of the grapple or angling left to right of the snowblade, for example. And now how you would control if you're gonna open or close the jaws after you've pushed this button and activated that control, on the back side up here on this loader joystick is gonna be a button. You can push it on this side, you can push it on this side. So basically, you'll be able to push it one side and then maybe it'll open the jaws. You push it on the opposite side and it closes the jaws. Same thing with the hydraulic angling blade. Push it on the one side over here, it's gonna angle this way. You push the button the other side, it's gonna angle back the opposite way. And so then if you wanna turn that circuit off, you simply push this button again, it'll stop flow from going to that circuit right there. Now we are on to possibly the coolest thing I've ever seen in a tractor. I have seen this before. I have it actually on my skid steer, but that's in the construction world. Over here in the tractor world, you just don't see this. And so you see these levers right here. Okay, it kind of looks like a traditional skid steer quick attach. However, you don't ever have to leave the operator seat to disconnect or reconnect your bucket or put on a set of pallet forks or a snow pusher or a grapple or whatever else. You can hook up, you can disconnect all from way up there. You either have to press lock or unlock, and then this is going to be the hydraulic part. So you push that, for example. I gotta tell you, that's just the coolest thing I've ever seen on a tractor. Wouldn't you agree? So while I have you here, I'm asked a lot about what a two-function loader means. And so I wanna show you what that's all about. This Kubota right here is a really good example. And basically what you can do with a two-function loader or a two-function joystick on a loader is basically you can raise up and hold that bucket level if you want to, or if you can lower it down and keep the bucket level or keep it curled. Basically you can kind of hold the position. It takes a little bit of practice to get used to, but I wanna show you kind of in action. So pay attention that this loader goes up and down as I kind of move around here. and keep that bucket in the same, this bottom edge right here. I kind of keep it parallel with the ground as I go up and down there. You can use this with forks as well, and it's very handy if you're trying to move equipment around your lot, for example, but I'll show you what I'm talking about. Well, that just about wraps up all those eight functions right there that we had to show you on this Kubota L6060. A unicorn of sorts, if you think about it in that regard. Not too many tractors out there are set up like that. If you've done something really cool, I'd love to hear about it. We all would, so leave a comment below. My goal is to show you something fun and informative at the same time in every video that I put out for you. So hopefully you found this enjoyable. If you wouldn't mind, give me a thumbs up, even a thumbs down, hit that subscribe button underneath the video, and make sure you check out that description right underneath the video. All sorts of cool stuff for us tractor owners. You